Hello guys, welcome to Desire School channel. My name is Milad and today we are gonna get into understanding how to create realistic interior render in Lumion step by step. First, import the model into the Lumion. In the next step, we should apply materials to surfaces. Materials are so important for creating realistic renders. I have created some videos about making realistic materials that are used in this project. If you want to learn more about Lumion materials, you can find links to this video in the description. I would highly recommend that watch these videos. Now it's time to work on effects. Before starting to add render effects in the scene, I would like to save some views, so I can access them later. Well, the first effect is shadow. The most important thing in shadow effect is being sure fine detail shadow and soft shadow options are activated. I am going to decrease a little bit brightness amount here, so we have more darker and obvious shadows. The next effect is reflection. Be sure to check the speed ray option and then use the edit reflection plane tool. We use this tool to make a very accurate reflection on planar surfaces. For example, here I use this tool for mirrors, glasses, table surface, and wood material on the floor and the wall, which needs accurate reflection too. You can choose only 10 surfaces with this tool. Okay, let's check the preview render. Now you can see the reflections become much more real. Now, I'm gonna add a sky. Go to the sky menu and choose real sky and then go for overcast sky. Choose one of these skies. To change the direction of a sky, use the heading option. Adjust this till you find a nice lighting in your scene. In this project, I love to bring more lights inside the room. To do this, increase the brightness and overall brightness option in the real sky effect. The next effect is a skylight. Let's know more about the skylight effect function. A skylight effect is gonna create a natural ambient light from the sky and make smooth shadows in the scene. Set the render quality to the high and then check these options. A skylight in planar reflection. A skylight in projected reflection. Increase the brightness to the end. A little bit less than 100%. Decrease the saturation till we have not much blue light in the area. Now let's do the color correction effect. Here I'm gonna increase brightness and contrast, because I need more brightness and more obvious shadows in the scene. Adjust limit low amount, because I prefer the highlights area doesn't get exaggerated. The next effect is exposure. Select it from the camera tab. Increase the exposure amount a little bit to make the scene brightener. Here I'm gonna use a trick to get more lights inside. The trick is using rectangle lights. Place them behind the windows and change the light's direction to the inside of the room and set the size same as window. Increase a little bit the falloff amount for these lights and pick a color near to the sky color for these light sources. I choose pale blue because we need to simulate the natural light coming from outside. Let's check the preview render. Now we have much better lights in the scene. I think the area is still a little bit dark, so get back to the real sky effect and increase the brightness and overall brightness a little more. Add global illumination effect and increase the sun amount here. This effect causes that the places are still dark and they are far from sunlight become more brighter. Once again, in the color correction effect, increase the brightness and contrast. Here I think after this change we have a better light and shadows in the scene. Let's take a test render again and check the results. Now I'm going to get back to the shadow effect and decrease a little bit brightness amount to have more obvious shadows. Increase a little bit the omni shadow amount. Now we have better shadows on the edge and surfaces are defined better. Now take another test render to see the details. As you can see, we have much better shadows on the edge. Here once again I increase the contrast from color correction effect. Now after applying effects, some of material shortage gonna be specified. In this step I modify the settings of the materials. You can see the steps and methods of this work in the material guide videos. Link to these videos are available in the description section. I would highly recommend you to modify the materials after adding effects. Okay, after adjusting the materials, I get back to the effects menu and add sharpen effect to the project. Reduce its amount below to 0.1. The sharpen effect cause that the details of the scene look much better. Then add bloom effect and again decrease amount to 0.1. The bloom effect cause that the brighter areas look much better. Add chromatic aberration effect to the project and set its amount to 0.1. These three effects make your render get more realistic, but use them in a very small amount. Add vignette effect. This effect creates a dark frame around the image and this causes more focus on the main subject. At the end, add analog color lab effect and choose one of these styles by your own. This effect changes the color tonality and makes image color more variated. Well, I added all effects that I needed. So let's take a final render and see the results. Okay, I think everything is good here. And the lights and shadows and reflections look balanced and amazing. Thank you for watching. See you later.